原创个性演讲，炫目视觉呈现，科学的先行者，艺术的探索者，文化的洞见者，讲述传奇的人生，不忘初心，不弃梦想。
我们马上请他带着我们走进他的世界。
每周五晚19:50，一人一世界。
9月25日，一人一世界，生命私人定制，中奖观众信息如下。以上中奖观众获得的奖品将由宝马旗舰店为您送货上门，请您耐心等待哦。
这里是由宝马五系冠名播出的《一人一世界》，宝马五系与坚持梦想者同行。大家好，我是主持人陈伟鸿，欢迎各位来到节目现场，谢谢大家。今天大家收看到的这一期节目是我们《一人一世界》本季录制的最后一期节目了。在这个舞台上，我认识了很多科技的先行者、艺术的探索者和文化的洞见者。如今穿过时间和空间的帷幕，在想象力和创造力的护航之下，他们一路前行。今天我们看到的他们的所作所为，他们的所思所想，不仅影响和改变着这个世界，而且也让我们跟未来的无限可能再次相遇。好了，今天此刻，让我们再一次走进他们的世界。
有这样一群人，他们来自世界各地，却有着同一种坚持。面对初心，他们愿意倾尽一生执着追梦。
When I was a child, I was fascinated with movies and TV programs that talked about airplanes and other fantastic flying machines.
And for many years, it's been my dream to enable disabled people to get up out of their wheelchairs and to stand and to walk.
Helping these individuals here and elsewhere.That's why I'm doing it.
我从小就是一个不折不扣的航空知识的发烧友。
It was a magical experience that I want to share with as many people as possible.
当源自内心的热爱与高新技术温情碰撞，让世界顶尖科技有了温度和意义。一人一世界第一季完结篇，特邀五位科技大咖齐聚现场，带我们走进他们的奇幻世界。想象未来，你可以驾驶着汽车在陆地和空中飞行之间自由切换，每天开着飞行汽车享受着飞天的速度和翱翔的梦想。它让一切成为可能，它不是天才，但一切源于热爱。
When I was a child, I was fascinated with movies and TV programs that talked about airplanes and other fantastic flying machines.
终将科幻电影的情节真实再现。他就是飞行汽车 Terrafugia 公司首席执行官卡尔·迪特里希。
I want you to imagine what your life would be like if you could fly. Imagine if you could dance among the clouds. Imagine if you could change the view from the front seat of your car from this to this. Imagine if you could fly over the traffic on your own schedule, whenever you need to go, just like driving. My name is Carl Dietrich, and I'm the CEO and CTO co-founder of Terrafugia, the makers of the flying car. When I was a child, I was fascinated with movies and TV programs that talked about airplanes and other fantastic flying machines. I wondered how I could help make those magical visions reality. The proof of concept transition was first flown in March of 2009. It was an amazing experience to see our first prototype take to the air for the first time. It's like watching your first child take his first steps. So Terrafugia is starting with a first-generation flying car that works inside today's regulations. The first-generation flying car is called Terrafugia's Transition. Transition is kept at home in a standard garage, just like a car. It drives on roads and highways, just like a car. It runs on normal automotive gasoline and convert from a car to an airplane in 40 seconds with the push of a button. In 10 minutes, you can be flying on your way to the airport nearest your destination over all of the traffic at 160 kilometers per hour. Terrafugia's vision for that first flying car for the masses is called TFX. TFX is a plug-in hybrid electric flying car that can be kept in a garage just like a normal car. It can be driven on roads and highways just like a normal car. TFX can take off and land vertically, like a helicopter, from an area the size of a tennis court, and fly over 300 kilometers per hour, direct to your final destination, avoiding the busy airports. Check out this video. Inspired to bring a practical flying machine to everyone. I'm very happy to share with you that through the hard work of many people, we're making great progress towards achieving my dream of bringing a practical flying car to the world. I'm Carl Dietrich. This is my world. Thank you.
Thank you. 谢谢卡尔让大家眼界大开哈，我觉得刚才我看到他的时候，觉得好像在看一个神奇的变形金刚。你想让他是飞机的时候，他就是；想让他是汽车的时候，他就又变成了汽车。其实我会开汽车，但是我想，如果有一天我要去开这个你称它为飞机的东西的时候，我是不是还得申请一本驾照啊
？Well, for our first generation product, you need to become a pilot in order to fly safely. For the second generation product, our goal is to make it easy enough that you don't need to become a pilot to fly it. You still need some training. It's our goal to bring it down to something that could be accomplished over the course of a weekend.
谢谢卡尔，谢谢。让我们期待着下一位登场的演讲者，有请。
有一种发明能让残疾人有尊严地站立行走，摆脱轮椅的束缚，解放双手，享受和健康人一样的正常生活。
For many years, it's been my dream to enable disabled people to get up out of their wheelchairs and to stand and to walk.
他坚信科技能够改变我们的生活。 他就是外骨骼机器人首席技术官瑞查德·利特尔。
Thank you. My name is Richard Little, and for many years, it's been my dream to enable disabled people to get up out of their wheelchairs and to stand and to walk. I'm the co-founder and chief technology officer of a company called Rex Bionics that's based in Auckland in New Zealand. And our business is a very simple one. We build robotic exoskeletons that enable disabled people to get up out of their wheelchair and walk around, just like you and I.Our business started 13 years ago when my best friend Robert Irvin was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, MS. And as a man with MS, it was likely that Robert was going to have to use a wheelchair sometime in his future. Now, we're both engineers, and we don't know how to fix MS. But about 6 months before his diagnosis, I'd built a small humanoid robot. And I jokingly said to him, why don't we build you a set of robot legs?Now, we thought we knew at that time something about the access and attitudinal barriers that people in wheelchairs faced.Robert's mother used a wheelchair from having had MS herself, and my mother used a wheelchair from having had a stroke. So walking has always become about health for us. And if you imagine as well how convenient it is, imagine what you've done in the last 24 hours, and imagine what it'd be like doing those in a wheelchair. You see, sitting in a wheelchair is just really bad for you. And anybody can use Rex. We don't discriminate by illness or injury.And the Rex exoskeleton is very unique. It's the only exoskeleton in the world that allows a user to stand and to walk without using crutches or a walking frame. And this is really important because it means that users don't damage their shoulders. But it also means that their hands are free to do whatever they want whenever they get to wherever they're going. Now, we've got two products. One of them's called Rex Rehab, and the other one's called Rex Personal. The rehab's used in a hospital setting, and it allows a patient to stand up and walk and perform exercises and stretches that they couldn't do in a wheelchair. And it allows their organs to align and move around in a natural way. Now, people using Rex at home, they get the benefits of the standing and walking exercise as well, but they do it while doing their activities of daily living at the same time, such as cooking or socializing with their family. They can be used in the workplace too. We have doctors who use wheelchairs who say they want to standand examine or even operate on a patient, or engineers who want to stand and work at their bench. And it allows you to do this because it's hands-free. And Rex has really progressed in the last 12 years. It's had a massive impact on the people's lives. And now we're busy developing the next generation Rexes that are lower cost, lighter, faster, and offer more functionality to the user. And as well as that, we're working on a new range of products, new robotic rehabilitation devices thatwould help people's arms and hands. And we hope to continue helping more people in the future with our unique technology. It's my passion and it's my honor to be able to help people with my work. Welcome to my world.
有一种眼镜能让盲人重见光明，从此让盲人能够独立生活和娱乐成为可能。全新的思想带来全新的改变。
看到国旗了，
就是一会儿大一会儿小，好像它在飘。
并将这种信念融入科技，让科技有了温度。他就是发明盲人眼镜的瑞驰·霍格尔。
你感受过黑暗的世界吗？如果你每天的生活都是黑暗，你会恐惧吗？
Hello, my name is Rich Hogel, and my dream is to help people who are blind. Think about the things you see around you every day. Beautiful scenery, friends and family, just activities of daily life, just looking around. But can I ask you to close your eyes for a minute and imagine that nothingness we just heard about was your reality every day? How different would your life be if you had lost your sight? Hello, I'm Rich Hogel, and Director of Product Development for WeCob Incorporated, and I'm here to tell you about an exciting new technology to help those individuals who are blind. The number of blind people varies across the world, 250,000 in the US, 70,000 in Spain, 4 million in China. 4 million in China alone. Helping these individuals here and elsewhere, that's why I'm doing this. And this is 80 years after it was introduced. In a time when we're building driverless cars, the best technology we have is the white cane. We should be able to do better than this. We see with our brains, not with our eyes. Consider this for a moment. We see with our brains, not with our eyes. For those of us who can see, our eyes capture the images before us. And these images are processed by the brain, giving us the experience of sight. Well, we figured out a way to provide those images to blind individuals. Well, we put them on the tongue. The tongue, I know, you're wondering about that, and I'll get to that in a moment. But it turns out it's one of the best places to provide additional information for someone who's blind. There's a very high number of nerve receptors there. So by gently stimulating the tongue with this device, with a moving pattern, we can provide some information for the brain to process. Provide something instead of nothing. Enter the BrainPort device. The camera, controller, and tongue display. And with the camera, in fact, is just a simple digital camera mounted on a pair of sunglasses. It captures the scene in front of you. Maybe a little example will help you understand how it works. Again, close your eyes for a moment and open your palm, and on your palm, draw a circle. You can very quickly understand what that is. And that's the same idea we're doing with the BrainPort and drawing simple images on the tongue. But because it's such high resolution, an individual can feel fine features. Now the stimulation is very gentle. It feels like soda bubbles on the tongue. So we have folks who can perceive shapes and sizes of things, whether something's moving or stationary. Blind children here in China have learned to recognize Mandarin characters and play the game of darts. In fact, they are better at that game than I am. But instead of me trying to tell you about these activities, let's have a video that will show them for you. This is Kevin. Kevin has been blind since birth. Has never been able to see. This is Eric, the mountaineer. He has no eyes. There he is on the rock wall. Are they really seeing? I ask that, you're probably asking that. And the answer is no. Well, for a young man to be able to enjoy the fireworks with his friends, like everybody else, it opens a new world of experience. As we move forward, I want to use the BrainPort, especially to help kids learn in the school setting, learn their numbers, learn the shapes, learn spatial concepts, help young adults gain job skills and open up opportunities for employment. If we can help more individuals become independent, their lives will be better, our lives will be better, society will be better. My name is Rich Hogel. This is my world, and that's my dream.
谢谢，谢谢 Rich， 谢谢谢谢 Rich， 一眼就认出了这个小朋友，大家还记得他吗？在 Rich 演讲之前，小朋友一个人独自面对着黑暗，但是我想，当我们有了这样的帮助视障朋友的眼镜，他可以来面对大家了。我们用掌声来欢迎一下宋波。宋波今年13岁，他来自北京盲人学校。他和很多尝试过这个眼镜的朋友一样，今天可能会告诉我们一些这个眼镜的神奇之处。技术真的不是冰冷的，它是有温度的，它是有情感的。我想问问小宋波哈，你戴了这个眼镜之后有什么不一样吗？
戴了以后可以，就是第一次的时候看见了梨。
哦，看到了梨，是什么样子的？能描述一下吗？
就是一个圆的，一头大一头小。
当时是不是特别的新鲜？
嗯。
还有没有让你特别激动的一种发现？
还有国旗。
国旗啊，看到国旗了。
就是一会儿大一会儿小的，好像它在飘。
好像在飘。可能这个是让我们大家感觉到最激动、最兴奋也最神奇的地方。像尺寸的大小，也许你可以通过触摸这样的感知去发现它，但是对很多视障朋友来说，没有这样的一些技术的帮助，可能很难去准确地抓住飘这种感觉。其实不仅如此，我听说宋波还用它来认字了，对不对？
对。
对，大家看一看。
一个人，这个大。
小宋波，你对这个眼镜有什么期望吗？你希望它未来能够怎么样更多的帮助到你吗？你可以跟身旁的这位来自美国的非常高个儿的叔叔来说一说你的心声。
就是和正常人一样看到真正的世界。
哇，小宋波可能比别的孩子更幸运一些，因为他更早地感受到了这个神奇眼镜的神奇之处。我相信随着未来技术的不断更新和进步，有越来越多的视障的朋友有机会通过技术的帮助去感受到这个世界更多的精彩。好，谢谢 Rich， 谢谢宋波。
提到无人机，你会想到什么？
无人机不只是送戒指和航拍那么简单。
机缘巧合，它与无人机结缘，它让无人机飞到田间地头，帮助农民解决难题，它让森林防火和救援变得不再艰难。看智能机器人如何在我们生活中展现它的全能应用。
我希望未来有更多的飞行机器人能够帮助人类解决一些人类原来解决不了的问题。
他就是极飞科技创始人彭斌。
扫描屏幕下方的二维码参与节目的互动，各位就会有机会获得由宝马五系为大家提供的宝马自行车、旅行箱包、宝马官方旗舰店的代金券等等，欢迎各位的参与。
大家好，我是彭斌，很高兴能在这里大家分享我的世界。我从小就是一个不折不扣的航空模型和航空知识的发烧友。也许是因为这份爱好，2007年的时候，我和我的两个朋友共同创办了一家公司，叫极飞科技。这家公司在过去的8年间一直专注研发和制造无人飞机，所以今天我们提起无人机的时候，我们一般会想到航拍 送戒指。但我今天要给大家的呢，不只是送戒指和航拍这么简单，它更多的在慢慢的改变我们的生活。首先是无人机的物流。今天大城市里面我们都知道交通的堵塞非常严重，你有没有想过一个问题，未来给各位送包裹的不是快递小哥，而是一台台无人飞机。当然了，快递的无人机不仅仅只适用于大城市里解决交通拥堵的问题，在偏远的农村交通不便利，无人飞机也是一个非常好的解决方案。无人机就像一只雄鹰，它在空中盘旋，机动性非常的强，它可以改变自己的视角，随时捕获到它想要看到的数据，它可以飞向交通事故的现场，它可以飞向火灾的现场，它还可以飞向灾难的现场，把这一些信息以最快的速度、最高的效率发送给对应的警察、政府以及救援的部门。下面呢会有一个简短的小视频，这个场景是不是非常壮观？大量的农田，未来有无数的无人机像小蜜蜂一样的飞，喷洒农药，防治病虫害的一些化肥、一些农药的。在2014年的时候，我和我的小伙伴在新疆待了很长的时间，我们认识了不少农民，他们非常苦恼一件事情，在7、8月份棉花开始长虫的时候，喷洒农药又是一件非常非常辛苦而且带有剧毒的一件事情。当我们用无人机提供农业的喷洒服务的时候，农民非常非常的兴奋和高兴，其实我们在他的眼里看到了科技的价值和意义。无人机随着技术的不停的发展，它自身也在不停的完善，它未来一定像汽车一样随处可见，这是我们思考的科技的意义，它将帮助更多的人。或许这是无人机真正的价值所在，我们希望无人机这项技术能够帮助更多的人，我们也会让科技更有意义，这是我以及极飞的使命，这也是我们的世界。谢谢大家。
遨游探索太空将不再成为航天员和科学家的专利，在未来普通人也能够通过他们的发明走进太空，就像是一场说走就走的旅行，让我们来近距离感受太空的魅力。
It was a magical experience.
他就是带领我们遨游奇幻太空的 X-Core 首席试飞员瑞克·希尔福斯。
I hope you will join us. Welcome to my world.Hi, my name is Rick Searfoss, and I am the chief test pilot of X-Core Aerospace. As a former pilot and commander of the space shuttle, I spent 39 days and nights in space during 3 separate missions. During that time, I learned how seeing the Earth from space is life-changing. We looked down just as we were passing over the eastern edge of China. We could see Beijing and down the eastern coast, Shanghai. The majority of the image was overwhelming when I realized how connected I felt to over a billion people that I could see all in that one instant. It brought home to me how we are all connected together on this incredible planet of ours as we hurtle through the cosmos. It was a magical experience that I want to share with as many people as possible. So when I left NASA and went into the commercial world, I sought out X-Core Aerospace. Since that time, I've flown two different X-Core rocket planes, 49 flights, along with three space shuttle missions for 52 rocket-powered flights. And I will soon be flying the first fully reusable suborbital spacecraft that launches from a runway all the way to the edge of space and then back, the X-Core Lynx. Now we're building our first fully reusable suborbital spacecraft we call the Lynx. It's designed to fly from the runway to the very edge of space up to four times every single day. We can carry a single participant in the cockpit right next to the pilot or a number of different scientific experiments. We hope to start the flight test on the Lynx by the end of this year, but we focus on safety first, so we will fly it when it's ready to fly. Hopefully by the end of 2016, we'll be ready to approach the regulators and ask for permission to fly with our first customers. This will be a life-changing event, one that customers will want to experience in different parts of the world and many times over and over. I hope you will join us. Welcome to my world. I'm Rick Searfoss. Thank you.
谢谢，非常感谢 Rick 带着他的技术，带着他的视角，引领着我们现场所有的人完成了一次思想和心灵上的星际穿越。当然对于一人一世界这个舞台来说，今天给我们带来震撼的还包括前面的各位演讲者。我们现在再次用掌声把他们重新请回到一人一世界的舞台上，欢迎他们。其实此刻再一次面对他们的时候，我想很多的人跟我一样，我们想看清楚他们眼前的世界和他们心向往之的未来世界究竟有着怎样的风景。我们从最远的 Rick 开始，好吗
？Well, to me, the future is what we decide to make it. People of goodwill and good intents and desires, serving other people worldwide, recognizing.Like I said before, we are all in this together on planet Earth.
Well, from my perspective, I think the future holds promise for those individuals who have disabilities. We're working hard to make that become a reality. And I think U.S. innovation, China compassion, equals 10,000 kids with new technology to help them succeed.
And I would just really echo the sentiments of my colleagues. It's wonderful. It's great to be here to see technology being used to make people's lives better. And that's my dream.
Developing new technology is about improving standards of living, giving us all more power, giving us all more capability to do more. And that's really what the future holds. Every one of us will be able to do more.
我希望未来有更多的飞行机器人能够帮助人类解决一些人类原来解决不了的问题。
现代的文明总是沐浴着希望的曙光，它会让人类在未知当中不断地去超越自己，不忘初心，方得始终。也许从那一刻开始，我们开始有了对这个世界、对这个地球最初的一个永恒的信念。 在这儿你会看到，无论是疾驰而过的科学，或者瞬息万变的世界，或者我们心向往之的艺术，从来都没有忘记自己出发的起点，因为这就是人类面向未来的一个又一个新的出发点，它会让我们看到这个世界更广阔的未来。
时间和空间的缝隙中，我们与这个碎片化的世界相遇，在这个散落的场域里，一人一世界采集一块块拼图，努力为你的灵魂找到最渴求的那块。他们是科学的先行者，他们是艺术的探索者，他们是文化的洞见者。
So these are all ideas. So it starts with the question why.
也许有一天，当外科医生放下手术刀，也能给病人治好病。
我希望呢，在这样的一个城市中间，每一个人都像叶片一样的，在跟云端进行一种交流和交换。
无论繁花落寞，他们都执着地沉浸其间，并享受这种情怀。
咱们去自己动手弹奏音乐的话，我觉得我们会发现这是一个全新的一种乐趣。
我的漫画跟幽默的关系啊，就像狗跟电线杆的关系一样。
这一辈子从事了我最钟爱的动画绘画事业，而且我自己感到我自己很幸福。
总是胸怀博大，他们勇于变革，重视传承，还引领了时代。
哪怕是这个世界只是因为我们改变了一点点，而这一点点也将是我们短暂的生命当中的闪光点。
And I know that the children of today will become the builders of tomorrow.
Hope spots in the ocean, hope spots on the land to give us a future for those we care most about.
把一个壮美的紫禁城能完整的交给下一个600年。
一人一世界，这一季再见，下一季这个拼图上还会出现谁呢？欢迎你走进他们的世界。
感谢各位收看由宝马五系冠名播出的一人一世界，宝马五系与坚持梦想者同行。下一季我们将会带着各位继续来领略人生当中你所没有看到过的风景。下一季再见。
But the technology of unmanned aircraft has advanced so quickly that many of those rules need to be updated to allow for the new technology of unmanned aircraft.
And I jokingly said to them, why don't we build a set of robot legs? Now, we thought we knew at that time something about the access and attitudinal barriers that people in wheelchairs face.
Helping these individuals here and elsewhere, that's why I'm doing this.
我们不停地在努力，让我们的设备